Greetings and salutations, everyone, and welcome back to RimWorld Ascension, episode 46. If you enjoy this episode, please remember to like and subscribe, and as always, mod list is down in the description. And with that, let's get into the episode. Alright, everyone, so the plans for this episode are, hopefully, to begin expansion over the river to claim this entire section, therefore doubling the size of our city here. Hopefully we're done with mental breakdowns. That was really annoying. Now that we have food and everyone's kind of coming out of it, it hopefully will be a little less so we can actually work. We're going to need to acquire a lot of wood because these initial walls will be made of wood as it is the most readily available resource, unfortunately. So we have to work with what we got, and what we got is hopefully a lot of wood. Let's also go ahead and get maize on the replanting of the hay grass and the heal root. Now that these greenhouses have been harvested and the soil has been retilled, we're gonna need it, seeing as we're also completely out of medicine. Let's also get Calhoun to deconstruct that wall specifically. And we have researched air conditioning, so now, if we really, really wanted to, we could make this into a freezer. But that would require us to get power generation, which right now would have to be a wood-fired generator, and I don't want that. Because I want to use one of these. Cargo pod weapons. What kind of weapon? That's a flamethrower! Alright, well, Michael, go ahead and go grab that for me. That's gonna be incredibly powerful. Let's also go ahead and send Storch out to go grab up all that special ammunition. Another cargo pod of weapons. Randy Random, I don't like that he is giving me all these weapons. That is mildly concerning. Michael's collapsed due to exhaustion. That sounds about right. Now, what do we load the flamethrower with? We load it up with the explosive ammo, of course. There we go. So now we have a fully loaded flamethrower. Perfect. Let's also go ahead and make sure all of our muskets are reloaded. And there we go. All right. Now we can quickly walk over to this side of the map, and we can begin work over here. More importantly, though, we can begin chopping trees over here, which will give us a nice supply of wood to build our new wall. Oh, Reek's gone berserk. That's not going to end well for him. Yep, punch down. That's what happens. Oh man, that guy's going to bleed to death though. Man, those sword claws are gnarly. We have researched a lathe, which means that we can now build reinforced barrels to repair mortars, and we can technically build components, but it is painfully slow. Not that we really can build components, we don't have a lot of steel. And we have successfully converted a buttercup. Now, I do believe that Buttercup is going to be enslaved. How many people is that going to be to enslave? Let's see. You're being recruited. You're being recruited. So that'll bring us up to a total of 4. All right. Well, now that we have a sizable amount of wood out there in the new area, let's go ahead and begin construction on the wall. And we are going to start constructing the wall down here. This is the most open area, so it's the area we need to have the wall built immediately in. There we go. So that will be the first wall that we build for our new base expansion. Alright, apparently Calhoun is still prioritizing wardening. I would prefer Calhoun to focus on the animals. David is now in confusion. To be expected. We're going to forbid building those fences. We're just going to let them wander for a while. And there's one of the most important things we needed to research. The machining table, which requires 150 steel, which we don't have. Joy. We're going to need a lot of steel, actually, now that I think about it. Because we're going to have to build this, which is 100, and this, which is also 100. And pipes, which are 2. Unless we just put the gas generator right next to the pump, which we could do. Looks like Pi ran out of stuff to build, but we do still need repairs to be done, and that is leveling them up quite quickly. Look at that, they're already almost level 7. They are considered a capable amateur right now. We really need them to repair over here. This place has been absolutely hammered by dynamite. Can they repair these walls? They can. And we've researched gunsmithing, which allows us to build some very old-style guns. Now all we need is more resources so that we can actually build them. Now, obviously, this wall will not remain made of wood forever. It's just a temporary thing so that there is something there. It will be very vulnerable to being lit on fire, though, as we have learned time and time again. And Pi just leveled up to level 7 construction, which now makes them a weak professional. Kyle Hunt is considered a very skilled professional at level 11. Pi is catching up quite quickly, which is good. Raid Athena Empire. Arrive nearby. Oh, it's a bunch of melee people. Oh, this is going to be a slaughter. Unfortunately, Latch is way out there. It said they are approaching from multiple directions. Yes, they are. Alright, Jaleel. Go to the hospital. So is it only the two of them? Let's see, so that's what? 11 there? 8 there? Honestly, I could probably just go out there and take these guys on in a one-on-one fight. Well, not one-on-one, but something close to one-on-one. Especially since they're using crossbows, which, as we know, take centuries to reload. I have a feeling we're going to end up using this choke point to fight. Just a hunch. Let's go ahead. We'll let Calhoun sleep. Calhoun is on the verge of a mental breakdown, and we need that to be not the case. Everybody else can go ahead and move down here to provide fire support if they foolishly try to flank us around. You only have a sword, so you'll have to go stand there. You can stand there. You can stand there. Let's see, Storch is correctly standing right there. There we go. Open the door. Let him in. Gotta do the war howl as soon as you get up there. Which should... Yep. Better melee. And it does look like they are being foolish and going the long way. They're not... Latch might actually make it back roughly... Well, not roughly, but safe. Alright, that's one. Alright, let's go ahead and have Michael open up this door. And just kind of stand here, menacingly. That gun got ammo in it right there? That one? No. Shame. Yes. Divert, you fools. That one's going up to Oh, good. Good job, Latch. You're distracting them. Oh my god, that's a lot of corpses. Oh. And we got half of them to flee. Alright. Go ahead and... No, not that. Shut the door. Is this person worth capturing? They have a bad back. No, is the answer. I will have Jaleel come up and capture him anyway, just so that we can close the door. And we'll have Michael stand off to the side. And these two need to make their way down here ASAP. Oh! They just decided to go straight through the front door, through the sidewall, okay. Dang, that was a steel wall too, and they just bashed it down like it was nothing. Unfortunately, they have decided to go and try to fight a Thrumbo, which is going about as well as one would expect when you're fighting a Thrumbo. Alright, well, we'll go ahead and go deal with them. Shouldn't be too terribly difficult. Yes, fight my hunting creatures. You two, start picking on people. And you're out of ammo. Congrats, Gweer. Go ahead and move up here, since you are now essentially useless. I forgot to set these guys to not fire at will. Yep, everybody's stunned. That Thrumbo is really holding its own. The other one just kind of ran away. David, get down here. Michael. Here. Let's see, turn those guys off, search and destroy. You know what? Let's go stand in front of the exit so they can't retreat. Now see, that's a good spot to throw a flash grenade. Like right there. Huck it. Stun him. Everybody got stunned. And now, run in and stab. Alright, Thrumbo's down. Is it bleeding to death? No, it is simply down due to pain. Kegel is unwaveringly loyal. That is unfortunate for you. Your gear is not even good enough for me to want to steal it. What's the range on those Molotovs? Far enough. Huck it. Ah, no, my critter! Go rescue the Ravager. Alright, start beating that fire out. That is getting a lot bigger than I anticipated. So there we go. We win. Let's go ahead and finish off Eagle over here. How long is it going to take for you to bleed out? 17 hours? Finish off. As for you, you're going to bleed out in an hour. You're fine. We are making some progress in terms of industrialization, but we really can't do a whole lot until we secure this area so that we can use the gas geyser. There is another one down here we could try to secure, but I don't think we're going to need more than one, at least not initially. Actually, I think those might be the only two on the map. Nope, there's a third one right there. That's pretty far out, though. Be a nightmare to try to defend it. Ooh, Nash had a growth moment. Let's see. Old enough to do the following work. Dr. Warden, construction, art, and entertain. Choose one skill for him during... He wants to be passionate about cooking, apparently. Okay. Let's see, Rebel, Find Palette, none of those are very good. We'll make him a Rebel, why not? And there we go, look at that, the southeast wall has been constructed. And now we gotta build the next one, up here. All right, let's go ahead, turn on that terrain avoidance so we can see what we're working with. Now, the reason I did this on this particular section of the wall is because, one, I can, and two, we can put a turret here, which will keep anyone from hopefully coming down this very unfortunate area. We will need to remove that one specific piece of granite, but if we put, say, an autocannon here, anybody who walks through here is going to be walking incredibly slow while being pummeled by an autocannon, or even just a normal turret. Just a normal turret there would probably dissuade most would-be attackers. And now we're up in the area where the insect ship is. And we're just gonna go ahead and do that, and then manually place a wooden bridge that we will then have to manually put the walls on, but that will be what the north wall looks like. Of course, eventually we might, you know, make little areas along it to put turrets, but for now, we just need a wall in general. Squatters. Oh, and our old base that we abandoned because it was an awful area. Yeah, it was Badlands. Well, I am not a fan of that. I don't... No, not 2 feet away from me. No. No, we're gonna go beat the hell out of them with only our melee guys. Why not? Let's style on them. And we'll go ahead and we'll send Jaleel with them to go do doctoring. Sure. No Jaleel. We'll just send the three of them. Yep. It won't even take a full day to get there. Oh, whoops. I accidentally removed the wrong person from the caravan. There we go. Add a latch to the caravan. Send the melee boys and girl to go get them and remove them from the old base. With extreme prejudice. I do believe they are on a medieval nation, so they shouldn't really have a whole lot of guns. And since they just set up, they're not going to have all that much in terms of defense. So we can wipe them out relatively easily, hopefully, if all goes well. Let's see what we're dealing with here. Oh, not a bad setup, actually. I mean, there's not a whole lot here to farm. There is 2 gas geysers, though. Like, right next to each other. That's actually pretty convenient. Wow. A lot more stuff living here, though. Strange. Alright, so what are we up against? Oh, no, a longbow. That's concerning. Not really. Alright, let's go ahead and start moving up, squad. Oh, they do have some sheep. I wonder if I can steal those. It'd be really funny if I did. Let's also get everyone together and do a wolf howl, a war howl real quick. Before he turns back into a normal person. Yeah, so my plan is we're gonna walk up and we're gonna stab him. Like, there's a choke point right here we can use against them. Man, we really need to get caught a proper prosthetic leg. This is a pain. Alright. So, in order to get in, we're going to have to bash this door down. Let's get to bashing. Oh, they're attacking our people. Perfect. Go ahead and switch over to your halberd. Okay, so what is going to be the strat here? Let's try just to break down this door really quick. Just focus on the door. see if that works. All right, there we go. We might be able to win if we can fight him more one-on-one. Or not. Caught up, maybe start running for the map edge. Death in 5 hours. Oh, they broke your armor. Hmm. I think we might need a bigger squad. Well, let's see here. Let's form a caravan to go to there. We're gonna bring some guns. And a doctor. The Latch is managing to hold the line. And is killing some of them. But has unfortunately died. Oh no. Well, there goes our cook. And I'm pretty sure Kata's gonna get got too. They are coming in hot. I don't think Storch is gonna be magically standing back up. Well, just try to hold the line, Storch, or Kata. Hopefully help is on the way. Caravan lost. Captured. But we might be able to rescue them if we send our squad. We are leaving the child kind of in charge of the base. Probably not the best idea, but... you know, hopefully the child can handle it. And here we are. And that is where I'm gonna leave this episode off. Next episode will be, hopefully, a successful rescue mission. So, with that, I'll see you all in the next episode. Enjoy the cliffhanger.